Well, think of the profound effect this will have on the morale of the American teenager. No, sir? Well, it's only that I didn't mean to, sir. 2 weeks from today, at the induction center. Okay, he'll be there. Thank you, sir. Oh, Albert! Our music company, Almalu, is being dissolved. Conrad Bernie's going to the army. And your faithful secretary is hereby submitting her resignation. It's no use, Albert. I've been with you for 8 years now. And you know that I've been a lot more than just a secretary to you. Albert?
Oh, those are moments of madness.
Well, between those moments of madness and the office, I put in a good 90-hour week. And for what? Besides, I want something more than that. Not a religion.
Rosie, if you're referring to anything, and if it's part of the company you're after, the answer is no to that, too. Avalu is me, Mama, and Lou, and any change in that would kill the wonderful woman who bore me.
Albert, nothing could kill your mother. Well, except for maybe a silver bullet.
Rosie, I've up to my ears in debt. Conrad's got a $50,000 guarantee, which I can't pay, and I've just taken a severe dose of aspirin.
Oh, Albert, will you listen to me? I'm serious, Albert. You've got to understand. Albert. Bum. You were going to NYU and become... an English teacher, an English teacher. If only been an English teacher, chosen at random, run 1,200,000 screaming, hysterical teenagers, it's gonna make Mr. Bury the hottest soldier since Joan of Arc.
Rose, I'm beginning to see it. We cut the record here in New York.
Take that greasy bongo playing ear thief to Sweet Apple.
Let him kiss the kid.
And release the record. Albert, you'll have enough money to stay in college the rest of your life.
Rose, it's wonderful, and I promise you, as soon as this thing is settled, it'll be just
Albert, us. Albert, dear, I have another call. Could you hold on? Yes, Mary? Well, all the phones in Sweet Apple can't be busy. Kim Matthew just got pinned to who? Oh, never mind, Mary. Call me back when you get someone, all right? Okay, thank you.
TV, you're not gonna go, "Oh, Conrad, I love you!"
crazy.
Kim, dear, could you please get off the phone? I have some calls I have to make.
Right, Mother. Sorry, Ursula, I've got to hang up. You'll explain everything to the other kids, won't you?
I guess I'll have to. Bye.
Bye.
Kim, are you sure? I mean, are you really sure?
Positive. After all, I'm 15 years old now, and it's time I settled down.
When you're a skinny child of 14, wired with braces from ear to ear, you doubt that you could ever be appealing. Then, hallelujah, you are 15, and the braces disappear, and your skin is smooth and clear, and you have that happy grown-up
to touch his clothes.
Now we've gone mad. Oh yes, we do.
no smoking until age 14. Let's begin that.
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do. We love you, Conrad.
Oh, little girl, you can sing with us if you like, too. What's the matter with them?
Oh, they're just upset because Conrad's going into the army and they'll be too old for him when he gets out.
Hi, I'm Albert Peterson, Conrad's manager. Oh, don't be like that. Things can't be that bad. Smile! Little girl, this is an adult speaking and I command you to smile. Please?
I'll leave taxis for my successful son. A mother can ride crowded in a dirty subway full of foreign people who wouldn't give you a seat if your life depended on it, but what's the difference? Nowadays, a mother is lower than dirt anyways. Well, here's some of the money I saved from not taking a taxi. Buy some candy with it, dear.
Thanks, Mama.
Who's she?
Mama, you remember Rose Alvarez from The Office?
This is Rose Alvarez? Pretty little Rose Alvarez? I can't believe it. Rose, what happened? Did you have a sudden shock or something?
Excuse me, Albert. I think I'll go down and see if Conrad's here.
Oh, by all means, Miss Alvarez. Just look at her, Sonny. See how nice she looks. It's a wonder to me some older man doesn't snatch her off. A personable matron like that with brains and a few dollars? What a catch you'd be for some complicit. Goodbye, Rose.
Goodbye, May.
Call me Mrs. Peterson. Now, Mama, what I wanted to talk to you about, well, it kind of concerns Rose.
Well, I know my sonny. He loves his mama. He isn't going to say anything that's going to break her heart. Go ahead, dear.
And
what about Rose?
And Lou. Has something to do with Lou.
Lou?
Yeah.
Where are you, Lou? Struck down by a beverage I consumed faithfully for 32 years. What about Lou?
Well, maybe we should take a walk and let's talk about it. See, Rosie thought, and I thought too, that I should give up Alma Lou. Mama, what's the matter? Are you okay?
Nothing's the matter, Sonny. You just killed me, that's all. Lou, I'm coming. I'm on my way up.
Mama, why don't you take a taxi and go?
I don't need a taxi. I will take the subway. Nothing is too crowded for a mother. I'll just wait and go during rush hour. That's the worst time.
Mama.
Now wait a minute. How many blocks is it after all? Only 107. I'll walk.
Mama.
Son, I want you to enjoy yourself and take care. Wear your heavy coat. Be careful crossing the street. Keep your money inside your pocket. Eat a hot lunch.
Albert, I thought you were going to bring it to her gently.
I couldn't tell her, Rose. I didn't tell her. She was so upset with me leaving that I just...
But Albert, you promised me that you were going to tell
He's
her.
Coming! He's coming! Conrad Pretty's coming! Come on, Rose. We gotta get to Conrad.
But Albert, you promised me that!
Later, Rose.
Albert!
Thank you. Conrad Birdie. Welcome to Sweet Apple. Now, before we escort you to the mayor's office where the mayor himself is waiting, I'd like to introduce you to the girl upon whom you have chosen to bestow your final kiss upon, and who will now recite the Conrad Birdie pledge, Kim McAfee.
Can I talk to you for a minute?
Right now? Hugo, I'm in an awful hurry. Can't it wait till later?
I don't know, Kim. It's kind of important.
Hugo Peabody, what is it that's so important that you have to talk to her right now?
What's so important? I'll tell you what's so important. The day after I give her my pin, she goes around kissing somebody else. That's what's so important. I'll tell you, I'm quite upset about this. I've already had several headaches and a nosebleed.
Why, Hugo? I believe you're actually jealous of Conrad Birdie.
Me, jealous? I'm the opposite of jealous. I'm very jealous. And I've every right to be. Kim's my steady.
That's just it, Hugo. I'm your steady. Oh, I may admire Conrad Birdie as one admires a far distant and unattainable ideal, but I'm pinching you, Hugo, and I don't care how common and ordinary you are. That's how I'm going to stay.
Oh, Kim, you're not just saying that to make me feel better?
I mean every word of it, Hugo. Conrad Birdie's just a fling. A steady is forever.
Just for you.
stop thinking about me and get my speech. Where's my speech?
It's right here in the briefcase.
Okay, well come along. Come on.
That's the way it should be.
Happens to me at breakfast, and I intend on enjoying it.
Please, Kim, your father has a right to enjoy his breakfast, but I'm sure he won't mind if we start putting away some of these little things. I know the house is a bit hectic this morning, dear, but Kim's gone through a lot of trouble making a special breakfast for Mr. Birdie, and I intend on making him enjoy it. Of course, it really doesn't mean anything to me, but for Kim's sake, I hope that all this mess will be cleared up. Thank you very much. Did you enjoy it, dear?
Good.
Now, move along.
Now, look here, Doris. You know perfectly well I'm not leaving this room till I drink my coffee, smoke a pipe, and read my paper.
I forgot all about your coffee, dear. How about a nice warm Mountain Dew?
Morning, Pot. Here's your paper. I hope you don't mind, but I have a few stories about Connor.
I've tried to run this house on a democratic basis. I've extended the privilege of self-determination to both the woman I have married and the children I have sired. The vote has been denied to no one for reason of age, sex, or political affiliation. There's been no taxation without representation, and open conveyances were openly arrived at. Last night, I gave up my room to a guest who repeatedly referred to me as Max. Telephone calls were made on my phone to New York, Chicago, Fairbanks, Alaska, and Hong Kong. I had to sleep in a camp cot with my feet in the fireplace and my head in an ashtray. While outside my window, three harpies shrieked, "We love you, Conrad," 4,723 times. I've just lost two fried eggs. Gentlemen, the democracy is over. Parliament is dissolved. Magna Carta is revoked, and Nero is back in town. And you don't offer an emperor a warm Mountain Dew.
Mr. and Mrs. McAfee, Kim, Francis, you don't mind staying off the phone for maybe 5 minutes? I'm expecting a long-distance call from New York.
Perfectly all right. I'll go burn Rome.
Thanks. Connor, what's the matter?
Oh, nothing, dear. Your father's just excited about Conrad being here. That's all.
Oh my gosh, he's coming, he's coming.
He's coming! Come on, he's calling the kids off. I'll get the egg. Girls, girls, you better get in here if you want to watch me.
Here we are, Kim.
I'm sorry, Doris. I hope you don't mind, but I just had to come too. I'll stand back here with the girl.
Here he is! Here he is!
Call me for lunch. Hey, Babs.
Now, look here, Doris. About that boy.
Please, Harry. He's just shy.
After all, Kim is only 15. I don't want her.
Please, Daddy, not in front of everybody.
Ursula, I think we'd better be going now.
Why?
No ill-mannered lout's going to...
Tell him, Pa!
You shut up.
Harry, you have no right to say that. He is our guest.
This house is mine until you're 18.
But Daddy?
You shut up until you're 18.
But Daddy?
Will you leave me alone?
Excuse me, folks. Is this the way you want 75 million people to see you?
What are you talking about?
You're going to be on television with Conrad.
On television?
That's right. Just got confirmation from New York. You're going to be on the Ed Sullivan Show.
You mean we're going to be on the Sullivan Show? The Ed Sullivan Sullivan Show?
To the American people out there, you're a dream come true. And for the free world's sake, Mr. McAfee, don't let that dream slip away.
Me, Harry McAfee, appearing with Ed Sullivan. Me, on the Ed Sullivan Show. Ed Sullivan.
Ed Sullivan, we're going to
grades. A good job, and now this. Greatest.
Well, this is it, Albert. What do you think?
It looks great, Rose. Now, what I want to...
Of course, it's been used as a movie house for the past 30 years. But I think it'll work great for the TV show.
It'll be swell, Rose. Now, if you'll just...
Now, they're setting the lighting and the cameras down tomorrow. Any costumes we
Rose,
need,
we can... I'm sure everything will be just perfect. Now, if you'll take a walk over here and sit down, there's something I'd like to talk to you about. See, Rose, it has to do with you and me.
You and me, English teacher?
I'm serious, Rose. I just want to tell you that being out here in Sweet Apple away from New York has made me see things in a whole new different light. And I just want you to know that I did write Mom and I told her that I would dissolve Amelie.
Albert, you didn't!
I did, Rose. And so far, not a word. It's been 3 days and three nights, so I think she's taking it pretty well. Come in. Mom,
3 days and three nights on the trailway bus.
But what's the difference?
I'm only a mother, and for a mother, a trailway bus is good enough.
Mama, what are you doing here?
Did you think I wouldn't come? A woman gets a letter obviously written under the influence of drugs, and she should stay at home? Oh, here it is. Oh, pay no attention, only a mother's tears. Dear Mom, this is to tell you that Almaloo is dissolved. Your friend, Albert. Almaloo is dissolved? Dissolve me! Who am I anyway? I'm just a sick old woman. Probably won't last tonight. I just want a simple stone with one word carved on it. Albert's mother. And never mind hiring a limousine to get me to my final resting place. I'll walk. And tell that Spanish friend of yours I forgive her. She knoweth not what she doneth.
Mama, Rose is right here.
This is Rose? For heaven's sake, Albert, send her back to Tibet. Well, don't worry about getting another secretary. Just so happens I met on the bus a perfect secretary, a wonderful, refined girl on her way to Akron, only I persuaded her to get off here. Sonny, I'd like you to meet Gloria Rasputin.
Hi, Al. Hey, you're kind of cute. Mama, I don't need a secretary. I've got Rosie.
What does Rosie need a job for? In her year or two, she can get Social Security.
Well, listen, I don't just type. I can dance. Hit it.
Thank you.
She's not to kiss Conrad Birdie on that Ed Sullivan show. Because if she does, I'll... Miss Alvarez. Excuse me, Miss Alvarez. Can I do anything for you, Miss Alvarez?
As a matter of fact, Hugo, I think you can.
Kiss, oh, give me one last kiss. It never felt like this. No, never felt like this. You know I need your love. Oh, 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 give me one last kiss. Oh, one more time. Oh, baby, one more time. It really is sublime. Oh, honey, it's sublime. You know I need your love. Oh, 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 give me one last kiss.
Eight years,
years being in love with that mama clutching that aspirin splitting that 6 foot tarantula. What did I ever see in him? How could I ever get involved that way? Now that it's over, I can smile and say, what did I ever see in him? Boy, I was way out on a limb. Now that my senses haven't found again, now that I'm safely on the ground again, what did I ever see in him? Is he tender? No, he's not. Is he thoughtful? No, he's not. Am I crazy? What's he got that I found so damn appealing? What did he ever do for me? Well, to be honest, he was sometimes nice, but still it wasn't worth that awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken dates, broken nails, broken hearts. How did I ever, why did I ever, what?
Don't be upset, Miss Alvarez. All men can't be like that.
Every single one of them. Well, except for maybe Albert Schweitzer, and I'm not his type. They're all the same. From puberty to senility. From Benedict Arnold to Mussolini.
Yeah, you know, I never understood why Ingrid Bergman married him in the first place.
Those egotistical, selfish human beasts.
Then what are we poor women to do, Miss Alvarez?
Well, Kim, we're supposed to use them. Let them be our playthings. While we live, sip from the cup of life. Mix those potions and drain them to the dregs. How do you like them apples, Mr. Peterson?
Do we need them? No, we don't. Do we want them? No, we don't.
Will we leave them?
No, we won't. Tell me, what did I say that color? What did we ever see in them? How could we ever think that they were nice? Take it from us, we paid an awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken dates, broken nails, broken hearts. What did we ever see in
him? Hugo F. Peabody!
Huh?
Hugo! What did I ever see in him? Why, he's just as bad as Mr. Peterson, if not worse. Miss Alvarez, I'm coming with you.
Now, wait a minute, Kim. You're just 15.
Juliet was 14 when she left home.
And look what happened to her. Now, why don't you just go downstairs like a good little girl and have some muffin cookies?
It's too late for cookies, Miss Alvarez. I want to live. We'll sip the dregs together. We'll help each other with our potions.
Last time, Albert, I'm okay, and I don't feel like getting into bed. Now, leave me alone.
Conrad, please be reasonable. You had a severe shock. Aha! There she is, the traitor that stabbed me in the heart while my back was turned.
Out of my way, Albert.
Be careful, Sonny. She may be armed.
I'm okay. I can handle her, Mama. Why don't you take Conrad upstairs and see that he gets into bed?
Conrad, come on. I'll make you a nice cup of tea.
For the last time, Albert, will you get out of my way?
Not until I've had my say, Rose. I just want you to know that the kiss will take place after all, thanks to Mama's quick thinking. Tomorrow morning at the train station before Conrad leaves. So you see, Rose, you failed. As anyone must fail who tries to buck Albert Peterson. One of the titans, the giants, one of the King Kongs of the music industry. I'm huge.
What did I ever see in him?
Awesome.
How could I ever think that he was nice? Take it from me, I paid an awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken dates, broken nails, broken hearts. Out of my way, you defrocked English teacher!
Please don't go. And I don't care how you beg and plead. break my bones, but words can never harm me. You big rat. I'm sorry to do this in front of you folks, but as you can see, I've had to let Miss Alvarez go. I'll get that.
Probably Hong Kong again.
Yes, this is Albert Peterson speaking. I'm sorry, Miss Alvarez is no longer with us.
Wait for me, Miss Alvarez! I'm coming with you!
And that's where right. Do you think you're going?
With Rosie! To drain deep the dregs and sip full and hearty the brimming cup! To live!
Upstairs.
But Daddy!
Do you hear me? I said upstairs. Now go!
Rosie was right! You're all the same! From puberty to Mussolini!
What's that? You dare say puberty in front of your own father. Not to mention Mussolini. Taurus, we failed as parents. I never asked much for my children. Just a little respect. That's all. Respect. But did I get it? No. I got no respect.
But I respect you, Pa.
I don't want your respect. You're a child. What good is the respect of a child? Take me upstairs. I'm not a well man. Certain words I didn't want to hear in this household. Puberty was the first, Mussolini was the second, and respect was the third.
Now look here. No newspaper can bulldoze me. You happen to be speaking to Albert J. Peterson, and you can print that in whatever paper you represent. It's not a paper, it's a magazine. It's not Mr. Lewis, it's Mr. Luce. Mom, Rosie, I need you!
Sonny boy, Sonny, where are you going?
Nowhere's Mama, it's stuffy in here. And to find Rosie, Mama, I love her and I want her back.
Well, is that all? Well, I thought it was something important. By all means, Sonny, go find your Lady of Spain and bring her back here. Oh, and when you get back, be sure and stop by the kitchen, take my head out of the oven, and turn off the gas.
Mama!
Well, it is a strange house. I don't want to run up a bill.
Mama, if you loved me, you'd help me find Rosie.
Well, you're right, son, I'll help you find her. Except maybe I better give you a message from Conrad first.
What message?
Oh, nothing to worry about, sweetheart. He just says he's going out tonight, and he doesn't think he'll get back in time to kiss him tomorrow.
Mama, why didn't you tell me this earlier?
Well, I tried to, darling sweetheart, but you kept mentioning a certain party south of the border.
I can't believe this. He knows how much this means to me. Conrad! Conrad!
Take it easy. I'm coming. Before you start hollering, Albert, I just want you to know that I've made up my mind. I'm tired of getting up 9 o'clock every morning, having people watch me eat my breakfast, and letting little kids poke me in the eye. I'm gonna go out, have some fun, meet a couple young chicks. Don't you understand, Albert? I'm tense.
Mama, do something.
Conrad, did you ever think in terms of a more mature woman?
Man, I hope I never get that tense.
Conrad, you can't leave. You can't leave without my permission. It says so in the contract. Mama, get the contract. No, wait. I'll get the contract. Conrad, you stay put, please. Thanks.
There are chicks just right for some kissing, and I need to kiss me a few. Man, those chicks don't know what they're missing. I got a lot of living to do. Sizzling steaks all ready for tasting, and there's Cadillacs all shiny and new. Gotta move, 'cause time is a wasting. I got a lot of living to do.
There are men of 19 or 20 who are suave and reckless and true. Older men will give a girl plenty. I've got a lot of living to do.
Go, people to see, everything for you and me. Hey, you girls live here, don't you?
Yes, Mr. Birdie.
So what's low down in this town?
Sweet Apple, Ohio was founded in 1852 by Jeremiah
mean, what do you do here? Where do you go to have a ball?
Well, there's the church basement and the sweet shop. And the older kids go to the ice house.
What's there?
I don't know. Ice, I guess.
It just so happens, Mr. Birdie, that the ice house is where people go when they want to be alone.
Hey, ain't you the chick I was supposed to kiss?
I am not a chick! I'm a fully grown woman, and I insist on being treated as such. As a matter of fact, that's why I'm leaving home.
Hey, now you're talking, chick. Come on, let's move. We got things to do.
Crazy clothes and all the races.
Sure to deliver to him right after I shoot him.
Shoot him? Rosie! I need to find Rosie!
Dear, you don't have a gun!
There's that Daisier rifle in the garage.
That's mine!
You shut up! I wonder where you can buy a gun this late at night.
Anyway, dear, it's broken.
Then get me anything. That bow and arrow I bought you last year for Christmas with the suction cup tips. My daughter has run off the loop with a fiend. Get me a water gun.
Kids, I don't know what's wrong with these kids today. Kids, who can understand anything they say?
Kids, they are disobedient, disrespectful of us. Noisy, crazy, sloppy, lazy, lovers. They're born on a Sunday.
Kids, you can talk and talk to your face.
Like we were perfect in every way.
swims, hits the loop the loop that hurts. Why don't they lower the draft age to about 11?
Kids.
I didn't know what puberty was till I was almost past it.
Kids, they are just impossible to control. Kids, if they're all the clues of their rock and roll, why can't they dance like we did? Rock and Sammy K.
Here's my Swiss Army knife.
A Swiss Army knife? Well, that could do some damage.
What's the matter with kids?
Put some rocks in it this time. Could you make me a vodka malted?
How old are you?
32.
Get out!
What about a beer?
Out!
Just let me sit here with an empty glass in front of me.
Beat it!
I demand to see the manager. Where's Maud?
I'm Maud, Charles F. Maud, and if you're not out of here in 1 minute, I'll take you by the scruff of your neck and throw you out.
All right, I'm going. This is the last time I do my drinking in this place.
Double bourbon, scotch on the side, no ice. And put a cherry in it. We'll make that 2 cherries. And bring on Anton, boys. Alvarez is the name, but I want you. Call me Spanish Rose.
Spanish Rose?
Get out! Now wait a second! You can't throw me out! It's my constitutional right to have a drink here if I so choose. And to get loaded here if I so choose. And to do any manner of wild and trashy things here if I so choose. This is Spanish Rose's coming out party. And when I say coming out, I mean
yeah?
Coming out. Ay, 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 ay,
ay, ay,
ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, Furthermore, even if I was this Rose, which I am not, the one thing that would certainly make me hang up is any mention of anybody named Conrad!
No, no, Rosie, please, please don't hang up. I won't mention Conrad. We'll talk about anything you want. You, me, I, anything. Oh, Rosie, please. Are you alone?
No, as a matter of fact, Albert, I'm with friends.
Hi, boys. Hi, boys. Rose, you've got to help me find Conrad.
And that's not all, Albert. From now on, the sky's the limit. Parties, balls, dances. Hey, what's going on in there?
That's none of your business. That's a private dining room.
Private for whom?
For men only, that's for whom?
Men only? Hey, that's exactly what I'm looking for. I know what goes on in these small towns. Out of Spanish Rose Way.
And so, fellow Shriners, by the power vested in me, now, before the recording secretary reads the minutes of last week's meeting, I would like to bring up a subject that I know has been on everybody's mind.
Before me. Kim's run off with Conrad to the ice house, and I can't get
Wait.
A drink.
Kim and Conrad, you said? Albert, I've got to call. Hugo, you stay here, and I will call Albert. Now, wait a minute, fellas.
first place? Well, if you ask me, Sonny Boy, you'd go straight home, climb into bed, and have a nice cup of tea.
Mama, I've told you this so many times. I love Rosie, and I've got to find her. So if you don't want to help me, then why don't you just go home? In fact, that's not a bad idea. Why don't you just leave, Mama?
What did you say, darling sweetheart?
I said, go home, Mama.
Would you mind repeating that one more time, sunshine of my existence?
Mama, go home. I don't need you anymore.
It's come at last. At last it's come. The day I knew would come, at least it's come at last. My Sonny Boy doesn't need me anymore. Well, what are you waiting for? Put me out with the garbage. Just throw me away with the used grapefruits and the empty cans of bumblebee tuna. Never mind putting the lid on, leave it open so 100,000 pussycats can walk all over a mother. Well, I've got good news for you, sweetheart. We got a report from the hospital today, and it's absolutely definite. I've got a condition. Never you mind what sort of condition, a condition. And if there's one thing doctors can't cure, it's a condition. I don't want you to worry, though. Fancy funerals are for rich people. Just wait till Mother's Day, wrap me in a flag, and dump me in the river. I feel better now. Everything is as it should be. My mother is lying on top of a sanitation truck, while her son is running around with Mexicali Rose in the saloons, who came over for the fruit picking season and stayed ruined an American woman's life.
Are you finished, Mama?
Yes, Sonny Boy.
Goodbye, Mama.
You're just like your father. You'd marry anything. Good night, Sonny Boy.
My name is not Sonny Boy.
Good night, Albert.
Yes, and if we don't find him soon, I intend on calling the FBI.
Today, kids who can understand anything they say. Kids, they are so ridiculous and so immature. I don't see why anybody wants them.
Just you wait and see.
They are just impossible to
control. You'll be old enough to
kids with their awful clothes and their rock.
That's refreshing. Of course, I do prefer a camel, but these will do. Well, here we are, Conrad. This is the ice house. Fun, isn't it?
Mm.
Of course, when you've been here as many times as I have, I've just been here with everyone, you know. Ursula, Deborah Sue, the Girl Scouts. Stronger than the chocolate ones, aren't they? Conrad, you seem a bit nervous. Maybe a drag on this weed would help relax you. Or how about one of those reefers I've read so much about? I can go out and get you a fix if you tell me what it is. When you've had a donkey on your back as long as I have. Conrad, you're trembling! Just because you're a few years younger than I am, I hope it doesn't make you feel uncomfortable. I'm 27 or 28, you know. One of the two. So you see, I really know the score. I even know some of the words. Canubian, premarital, jailbait.
There you are, oh sensuous one. We've been looking everywhere for you.
That's nice, but out of my way, I'm late.
You don't understand. We're coming with you. You said it yourself. We got a lot of business.
Now wait a minute.
Moonlight swims.
Motorboat races.
Yeah.
Of course, that stuff really ain't as much fun as I made out.
We can start now. Let's have an orgy!
What do you have to say for yourself now, Mr. Birdie?
Thank God he's come.
Hi, everybody. Good old Hugo again.
Hugo, darling, you're just in time. I can't tell you what humiliation I've been made to suffer.
That's all I needed to hear. Take him away.
Mr. McAfee, I demand you release that boy.
Sorry, no doing.
This is Albert J. Peterson speaking. I demand you release...
This is a new Albert you're speaking to. I'll handle it.
Oh, by the way, Rose, did I tell you I love you?
Not yet, Albert.
I do. Conrad!
It's going to be such a wonderful life. I'm going to be Mrs. Peterson.
Oh, Rosie, nothing can stop you now.
Hello, Rose.
Hello, May.
Well, we're alone at last. Do you have time for a heart-to-heart with an old friend?
Oh, May, I'll always have time to talk to you. The woman who, by tomorrow, I shall be able to call.
Don't say it, Rose.
Oh, May, I will be able to call you mother.
Oh, the cruelest word I ever heard. To think I'd have lived to see the day I'd have relatives in El Salvador.
Oh, not to mention Guatemala, Chile, Brazil, and Chichi Casamango. And after I marry Albert, I'm going to stick a rose in my teeth, sit in front of my adobe hut on Central Park West, and sell tortillas. Adios, Mama.
Adios, Rosita.
Oh, call me Mrs. Peterson. I'm just a Spanish tamale, according to May. Right off the boat from the tropics, far, far away. Which is kind of funny, since where I come from is Allentown, PA. You want Spanish, May? I'll give you Spanish. I'll be Spanish. Just wait until I marry Alberto. I be the ghost of Chichi Castanengo, and I'll be behind my castanets with pink. I'll hide behind my fondo bartango. I'll be so Spanish it will make you sick. I'll eat the tacos and the enchiladas. I'll drink tequila till I feel no pain. The only song I sing will be Granada. I'll be more Espanol.
Advice to cross Spanish roses in one.
I've used all my life savings to get you out of that jail, and I don't want you seeing until we're out of the state.
Well, listen up, dude. Whether you pay me no guarantee or not, you got a contract with me forever.
Conrad, what are you saying?
Well, here's a blank piece of paper. I've signed it to Albert. You just fill in whatever you want.
Hello, Albert.
Mama.
Rose, you look better than usual. Well, don't worry. I know all about you, too. I won't make a fuss. I'll do what any sensible mother has to do. Don't. Goodbye, dear. Don't worry about this coat. You'll have 3 mink stoles as soon as the train passes over me.
Mama, enough of this nonsense. Can you please get on the train and go? Just get on the train.
Mr. Peterson, I demand to know what you've done with Conrad. He's not in that jail cell.
How should I know where Conrad is? I'm here saying goodbye to Rose.
Now, Mr. Peterson.
Dear, don't worry. The sweetest thing happened. Hugo proposed to Kim, and she accepted.
No.
What's wrong, dear?
My life is over. I'll sell the house and move into a home.
All aboard!
6:30 on the button. Hey, where's the train?
Oh, it left at 6:25.
But Albert, you told me to be here at 6:30.
With Conrad.
I know that because when you told me...
And Mama.
Wait a minute, Albert. You wanted us to miss the train?
Well, see, Rose, it stands to reason why get on a train in New York when we've got tickets to Pumpkin Falls, Iowa.
What's in Pumpkin Falls, Iowa?
An opening in the teaching staff of Pumpkin Falls Junior High.
Oh, Albert!
And I hope you brought your papers, Rose, because they want the applicant to be married.
Albert!
Oh, Rose, we've got a lot of living to do now.
Anything to say?
A lunch for next week.
There you go. Good job.
job tonight.